The warning was sounded by Philip Bessiger, a nutritionist. He noted with concern that because of the continued degradation of environment, people are experiencing harsh conditions. He added that cough and flu have become so common during the dry season. Bessiger appealed to Ugandans to engage in tree planting to save the environment, which is contaminated with carbon emissions.
It is contaminated with carbon emissions, and carbon emissions would be contained if trees had not been cut, because the leaves of trees take up most of these carbon emissions. But once you don't have what to take them, then they will saturate, the environment becomes contaminated, and when you breathe, you will reach levels where your respiratory system can't tolerate them, and therefore you end up having signs and symptoms of cough and flu during such a period of time.
Bessiger encouraged people building to always keep their fence wall low, limit pavers in their compounds, and keep them green. He noted that high wall fences affect the flow of air.
You need trees to be planted around your house because you need your lungs to perform efficiently. And the trees we have in our environment are the lungs we have out there. For those who build fences around their houses, build them low and make sure the air is flowing freely.
Ugandans have been advised to always stay hydrated during the dry season. This will enable them fight against viruses that cause cough and flu, as Noel Kansime, a nutritionist working with Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital, explains.
Flu or sneezing or coughing is a way that a body notifies someone that there is a foreign body in the airway. So during the dry season, the air is much drier. Most people are not taking in a lot of fluids. They are not well hydrated. So the airway gets inflamed, and it is easier for the virus that causes flu to invade the body and cause a common cold. So in terms of nutrition or home remedies that we can use, are the foods which are usually rich in the vitamins.
Halson Kagule, the Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital spokesperson, challenged Ugandans to always reach out to hospitals around them and seek health advice from experts, especially on the kinds of food to eat. He was concerned to see that there are still many cases of malnutrition in districts of Ankole, a region considered to be the country's food basket.
The rules and also the mandate of Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital is to offer technical support and guidance to other lower health facilities within this region in areas of giving them maybe possible information in regards to how they can use the readily available foods to address the emerging and re-emerging health concerns in relationship to nutrition.
Report compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.